Maureen Farrell joins us. She writes for CNNMoney.com and has been following this story for a while. Maureen, for people who may not be familiar with Stephen Cohen, he's a bit of a recluse. He's not a household name, but this is the most feared man on Wall Street, pre-Berard, the U.S. attorney, really landing what has been the big fish that has eluded government officials for so long.
It is. I mean, he's landed it. This is a record time. We've never seen anything of this magnitude, and Stephen Cohen is one of the richest men on Wall Street. That said, I mean, what we're still waiting to hear is whether or not he will face criminal charges. I mean, there's also this idea that the U.S. attorney wanted to put him in jail. He says that this deal does not offer any immunity to Cohen or anybody else. So that's really what we're going to wait and see. $1.8 billion, that's a huge sum.
But small compared to the fortune. And you're right, exactly. They got closer than they ever have before and shut down potentially managing for outside investors. But they didn't get anyone to turn on mm-hmm. him, really. There were a lot of questions about the case. They just didn't have the case to bring it criminally. What does this do for Wall Street? I have heard a lot of people say to me, the reason he was so powerful is because he was the biggest payer on Wall Street. They just have so much liquidity, people worried about what it means for bank profits. Also, what it means just for liquidity in the market. Mm-hmm. I mean, that is how central this hedge fund was. Not only in Wall Street, but in global trading circles.
It's huge. I mean, that's why it says a lot of banks have kept on working with them. It's going to be really interesting right now to see, now that they're going to plead guilty, whether banks will keep on working with him and taking his trades.
That's the question, right? Because even though he's able to manage his own personal money, is he too toxic
exactly.
for banks who are trying to repair their own reputation to deal with him?
But that said, the commissions are huge. Even with, it used to be $15 billion, now it's $9 billion of his own money that he's trading on Wall Street. It's huge, still a huge sum that still makes it one of the bigger hedge funds on Wall Street.
Pre-Berard all along has said that he wants to break this pervasive culture of insider trading where, you know, the people on the inside, the banks made all the money at the expense of the little guy who is in essence, you know, getting ripped off in this process. Is this going to change things? I mean, will this act as a deterrent, or is the jury out on that?
I think people say already it has. I mean, he has put people in jail already for insider trading. We're seeing all these fines against the big banks, particularly in the hedge fund world. They say it's been a huge deterrent already. I think it's been 75 convictions out of 87 cases that they've brought before the courts. So his record's stellar. We haven't really ever seen anything like this. He's really gone on the attack. This was the big case that he was waiting for, and they've won the U.S. Attorney's office.
They'll see. Yeah, it's always hard. I'm always a bit skeptical when somebody that says they're going to stamp out greed on Wall Street, but if at least they know they're being watched and they steer away from this insider trading and make the system a little bit fairer, then he'll have achieved something. All right, fascinating story. Not over yet for SAC.
Exactly.
Maureen Farrell joining us. Thank you so much.
Thank you.